what a shot. Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever back with more LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Now, before we get into the next level here of the Phantom Menace, I actually wanted to show off the character customizer in more detail and actually go and create somebody here. Because it occurred to me, I don't think I ever showed this off in LEGO Indiana Jones, so I figured, why not just have a little fun with it here? I have no idea who or what, I have no idea what I'm gonna make here, man. I definitely know I kinda wanna go for something wacky here. See, I like this guy. I like the Cantina bandmate head here, so I might just stick with that. But actually, you know what, I will stick with that. I think I'll stick with him. He's kind of an oddball looking fella there. So yeah, I won't give him a hat. We'll do that. What other heads do we have here? I love how they included scarred up Anakin after he burns on Mustafar there. That's pretty neat. I don't know who this guy's supposed to be, but he needs a shave. Oh, that's the scout trooper face right there. Oh, that's the guy. That's the co-pilot in the Millennium Falcon. The Hutiuti, that guy. There's all kinds of choices here. I like the droid head. I like this guy. We could go with Hammer Face here. There's so many choices, man. I think I'll just stick with old bandmate here. Lightsaber. Nah, I'll give him a shiny old pistol. Yeah, I'll give him a gun. I might give the other character a pistol here. What is this guy gonna wear though? It's the real question. This is already turning out to be quite something. See, that's the thing. We don't have a whole lot of characters unlocked. Ooh, I like that red. We don't have a whole lot of characters unlocked, so, or at least so far. So maybe I'm digging this red right here. Maybe I'll just stick with that. The Wooher, the Cantina, or yeah, Cantina bartender, his clothes there. Let's see what we can... I'm not sure what that is supposed to be. Yeah, like I was saying, we don't have a whole lot of characters unlocked, so we can't... we don't really have a whole lot to choose from right now. Oh, choose from right now. Look at this. Just letting it all hang out right there. Is that the same shade of red there? I think it is. Yeah, what the hell. We'll just stick with that. I like the gold. You know, maybe I'll just stick with the gold pants. I'm kind of digging the gold pants right here. I think I'll just do that. And then, yeah, we'll give him black hands, like gloves. He could be like an assassin or something with a fancy cape or something like that. I don't know. But this guy, I think we'll go with this guy for the time being. And I think maybe later on I will. Create a couple of... Maybe I'll cycle through different design choices later on throughout the series. Let me just go ahead and... Wait, I think I passed it. There we go. Set that up right there. Yeah. Go ahead and set up the name here. Head on back. That's the only tedious thing about this, though, is having to scroll through... scroll through and make each character blank so that your name doesn't appear all weird in the selection screen. Come on, there we go. And then this guy, okay. Perfect. I think we'll go with that right there. Hell yeah. All right. Well, anyhow, now that I kind of showed that off a little bit. Where were we here? We're back in the Phantom Menace. The Phantom Menace. And, oh, that's right. This is, get out of here, gonk. This is an interesting one. We have Chapter 4, Mos Espa Pod Race. Now, this level is really... This level's interesting because I, for some reason, can't seem to skip past the screen. There we go. This level is interesting because this underwent quite a few changes since the original LEGO Star Wars the video game. And really all for the better, but you'll see what I mean as we get into this more. I'll explain kind of how it works here. But in this version, in the Complete Saga, it's a pretty fun level, I gotta say. Oh, and we just don't have enough for the hyperdrive, because Obi-Wan freaking broke it. But anyhow, It's off to the races! The pod races, I should say. And, oh, look at the pit droids. Pit droids are bantering and running for help, and I think the audio might have desynced a little in this cutscene slightly, but that's okay. Anyhow, we have the start of the pod race here. So we get the countdown, and we're off. So when you start the pod race, and you can see we're on lap 1 out of 3 there, when you start the pod race, make sure you hold the joystick forward to go faster, and you want to get as many of the... Oh, there we go, nailed it right there. We just collected a red brick, the red power brick for this level, which means we will be unlocking this level's bonus extra. And there's our first mini kit. We will be able to get... Ah, the Tusken Raiders are making trouble for us. We'll be able to get 9 out of 10 mini kits in this level. But as you can see, this is the first of many vehicle levels, and it is very, you obviously just want to make sure you land on all the green arrows there, because our objective here is to beat Sebulba by the end of the race. That's what we got to do to beat this level successfully. Now, it's interesting, when I was mentioning a second ago about changes made to this level in the original LEGO Star Wars, the video game, used to be so... It was one of the worst levels, because it was just so infuriating to play, because the controls were just wonky, and just, you know, nothing handled correctly, and on top of that, you were... Damn. Shove that poor guy into the rock there. But, yeah, it just controlled so poorly, and you moved so slow, and it was just... It really has improved quite a bit since the original game. And we gotta be careful we don't hit any rocks here and not get shot by the old Tuskens here. And we should be very close to... Yep, there's True Jedi. True Jedi is easy to get in this level. And we're right on Sebulba's tail here, which is nice. We can go ahead and make our way through there and out in here into the open field. The open dirt field. Let's see if we can get ahead of him here. Yeah, because if we lose the race at the very end of lap 3, we will have to start from our nearest position. But yeah, the old version of this was just so... It was so difficult to control and impossible to make, like, turns and all that kind of stuff. There's minikit 9 out of 10. And see, up there is a door that we need a TIE fighter to access, and that's where the last minikit is. Come on, Sebulba, I gotta get past you somehow. I know you really want to win this race, but no, I got stuck. getting shot up here. Yeah. And the worst part of it is, in the original version, is that you were timed. You had to beat some of these areas. You had to get to the next section in, like, a timer would appear, and you would have only, like, 10 seconds to get to the next area, and oftentimes you had to restart that section just because it was impossible to get through in time. And they did away with that here, thank goodness. But we win the race! We won the pod race! Which is great for us, because Anakin just whips the prize money out of his pocket there. They definitely rigged that race. They knew he was going to win. But anyhow, R2 will carry the hyperdrive up there for us. And, oh, come on, Obi-Wan, you can do it. You know what to do. Just give it a... Ooh, give it an old smack. Give it a smack, and it'll smack you back. Damn, we just actually flew into the desert mountains there. That was pretty wild. But anyhow, we unlock the power brick detector, which is something that we'll be using a lot in free play, and we unlock Anakin's pod. So, with that, we already know we get True Jedi and studs and mini kits and all that. But, oh yeah, there's our gold brick tally, and I already skipped past it. But anyhow, we're done with that level, and it's a very short level. So, I think, strangely, because this episode is so short, I actually want to go ahead and end it here, because the next level, Retake Theed Palace, is... It's not a monster of a level, but it is the longest level of all the Phantom Menace chapters. And so with that in mind, I think what we'll do is... Actually, let me check on that. It's still open. Okay, let me... You know something? Let me, I'm gonna... What if we actually go in here? Was the... Oh, it's open. This shouldn't be... This is too weird, man. This shouldn't be open. Well, anyway, spoiler alert. Yeah, going in here... This introduces something called the Bounty Hunter missions. Now, oh, I see. It's a little bit different. So, yeah, basically what happens is what normally is supposed to happen is that this door is locked. And you can see up there, it's Jabba the Hutt's face on there. This door only becomes unlocked, well, it should only become unlocked, after you have purchased all the Bounty Hunter characters. Once you've done that, you will be able to come in here and go up to this counter and talk to Jabba and select... from 20 Bounty Hunter missions where you have to find various characters hidden throughout different levels. But I can see here that, well, obviously we can see here that we can't select anything because there's nothing, you know, we don't have all the Bounty Hunter characters. I hope this doesn't, like, glitch out for me later on in the series. That would suck. But anyhow, that's enough fooling around out here. And we are up to... How many gold bricks are we up to? We're up to 8 out of 160. Again, so many more to go. But we'll be okay. We'll go ahead and head on back into the cantina here. Have ourselves a nice drink. And prepare ourselves for the next level next time. So until next time, this is Lightning Bolt Forever. And I'll see you later.